Hello children, let's start with the next topic of the chapter 2, components of food for science class 6. Yesterday we have learned about balanced diet and the percentage of nutrient that should be present in balanced diet. But today we are going to study about undernutrition and malnutrition. But before starting these two topics, I would like to introduce what do you mean by nutrition and malnutrition with you. So undernutrition means if a person is taking lesser amount of food than whatever his body required, even if food is balanced diet, then also his or her body will suffer from undernutrition. That means if any person is taking less amount of food then whatever body is required, then the person will suffer from undernutrition, and on that condition the body will not grow and showing its all activities properly and also not getting the energy for day-to-day work. Now let's start the topic. In the previous section you have learned that to stay healthy we should take balanced diet in the required amount. Less than the required food, even it is balanced, will make us weak and sick. Such an unhealthy state of body due to the intake of lesser quantity of food is called undernutrition. So if you are taking lesser amount of food then whatever is body is required, then your body will suffer from undernutrition. And undernutrition may be due to the following reason. The first one is due to poverty. Poor people often either they suffer from undernutrition. Poor people, because of lack of money, they are not getting or not unable or not able to buy sufficient themselves. So that's why due to lesser amount of food, whatever they get every day, they are suffer from undernutrition and their body is not getting the proper nutrition, whatever is required for their body. Now second one is due to the non-availability of food. Sometimes due to reasons beyond the control of people, sufficient food might not be available. For example, during natural calamities such as flood, droughts, etc., the food may not be available. Yes children, during the natural calamities like floods, droughts or during the earthquakes, sometimes the life becomes too much miser, and on that condition also we are not getting the sufficient amount of food. Even if we have sufficient amount of money, but we are not able to buy the food on that time because of these natural calamities or maybe some other reasons. So on that condition also the body is not getting the proper amount of food and hence we are suffer from undernutrition. Now comes to the next term, that is the malnutrition. Malnutrition means if you are taking sufficient amount of food but only one type of food if you are taking every day and there is a lacking of certain type of nutrients in your food, then your body will be suffer from malnutrition. Sometimes our diet may be lacking in one or more nutrition. In such a situation, even if we eat sufficient food, our body does not get the required nourishment. As a result, we may get weak or fall sick. Such a condition in which people become weak and sick due to lack of one or more nutrition in one's diet is termed as malnutrition. So children, as I told you, even if you are taking sufficient amount of food, if you are thinking that I have taken sufficient amount of food, it is not less. But if you are taking one type of food regularly and it is lacking one or two nutrients, then your body will suffer from malnutrition. And on that condition also, your body will not show its activities properly. Thus, malnutrition may be either due to carelessness or lack of education, and it's due to carelessness or lack of education, because the people though are not knowing about malnutrition, if they are not bothered that nutrients are very, very essential for our body. So we should take every types of food. So on that condition, their body will suffer from malnutrition. Now, both the undernutrition and malnutrition retarded the growth and cause mental and physical disabilities in people of all age group. So children, both malnutrition as well as undernutrition is very, very harmful for us and also cause mental and physical disabilities in people of all age groups. See this child. This child is suffer from undernutrition as well as malnutrition, that is PEM, protein energy malnutrition. The growing children are affected very badly by undernutrition and malnutrition. For example, if a child gets lesser carbohydrate and protein in his diet, he suffers from protein energy malnutrition, which is in short called PEM, P-E-M, PEM. See the condition of the child. He has very lean and thin hands and legs. His belly is swollen abnormally and also having pale face, irritable face, and also is suffering from lots of diseases. So that is called undernutrition and malnutrition. Actually, this boy is not getting his diet properly, or maybe his diet is lacking from any of the nutrients, whatever is needed for his body. A child suffering from malnutrition falls sick quite often. So those child who is suffering from malnutrition, whose diet is not getting all the types of nutrients, fall sick quite often. A malnourished child does not need costly medicine or tonics. He should be given the required amount of balanced diet. And on that condition, what we should do? Yes, in that condition, the child doesn't require costly medicine or tonics. In that condition, a child needs proper amount of balanced diet food. The food which contains all the nutrients in right amount, in a right quantity. That child needed that on that. He get the balanced diet in a proper quantity, his disease will be cured fast. Now comes to obesity. So obesity, overweight and bulkiness of a person's body due to the excessive accumulation of fat in it is called obesity. Obesity means, as I told you children in the earlier of this chapter, I think in second video or third video of this chapter, that the storage of fat, as you know, that fat produce more energy in our body. That's why it is called energy bank of our body. But the fat within the limit is okay. But if its storage in our body is beyond the limit, then it causes a disease that is called obesity, which is also in Hindi. Causes of obesity. The cause of obesity are, what are the causes due to which obesity people? The first one is overeating, particularly fat rich food. These all cause obesity. Or overeating, some children or some people eat lots in one time, or overeating something. So due to overeating or due to lots of spicy and oily rich food, they are suffer from obesity. Hormonal imbalance. Yes, in the it is all hormonal imbalance due to secretion some of the hormones, which is much for them causes obesity. Third is metabolic disorder. The person who is suffering from high blood pressure or high blood sugar or high cholesterol, sometimes their hormones also, their metabolic system also get damaged and cause obesity in them. And the fourth is lack of physical work, exercise. Yes, children, that is the most common reason, I think so. Because many people have the habit to overeat but are not doing any exercise or any physical work. So, and their work is also to sit at one place and doing the work. So, that's why also the obesity caused in the people. A way to control obesity. How to control the obesity? If a person is suffering from obesity, then how to control it? There is some measures which the person should follow. Obesity can be controlled by doing physical exercise regularly and regulating the lifestyle. Yes, every day the person should do morning walk as well as physical work and physical exercises in order to control the obesity. Second is taking medicines to correct hormonal imbalance or metabolic disorder. If obesity is due to hormonal imbalance or due to metabolic disorders, then the person and take the medicine. Third is avoiding high fat and high carbohydrates food. And also, it is not only for obese people, but we all should avoid the high fat and high carbohydrate food. Whatever is required for our body, the limit is given. Only within that limit we should take the food. Otherwise, we should avoid the overeating. Now, obesity is a health hazard. It is known as health hazard. Very, very harmful for our body, which cause lots of diseases in our body. How is it? Let's come to this point. Obesity is a serious health hazard. Obese people are not active and may suffer from any of the following diseases. So the people who are obese may suffer from so many diseases. The first one is increased cholesterol in their blood. So cholesterol also get increased due to obesity, children. Cardiovascular disorders such as hypertension, high blood pressure, arteriosclerosis, blockage of artery and coronary attack means damage of heart, the main vein of the heart. These all disease may occur in obese person, and also diabetes, that is sugar, blood sugar. So all these disease may cause in obese people. So children, we should avoid the stale, oily, spicy and junk food to avoid the obesity. The continuous deposition of unused fat under the skin and around the abdomen makes us obese. So children, obesity is very, very harmful for us, and we should be careful for our physical fitness. Now there is an oral question. Let's solve these questions. Give two reasons for malnutrition in children. Two reasons for malnutrition in children, that should be carelessness or lack of education. Carelessness or lack of education. Mention one effect of malnutrition that we can tell PEM, which is called protein energy malnutrition. You can also write its full form, protein energy malnutrition. How can we obesity be controlled? So obesity can be controlled by doing exercise, physical exercise, taking medicine, and avoiding high fat and high carbohydrate food. So there is a less space here. You can write with the pencil, avoiding fat and carbohydrate rich food. Name a disease which is developed due to obesity. So you can write here, so many diseases are here. Hypertension, diabetes, coronary attack, etc. These all can be caused due to obesity. So I think this is enough for today's class. We will continue this chapter in our next class. Thank you. Have a nice day.